We just have quorum, so I hope all of you can stay the entire time, otherwise we can have a shutdown. I just wanted to let you all know. We're going to start with public forum, so if there are any guests of the SGA who would like to address the SGA right now, you have an opportunity. Otherwise, you'll have another opportunity later in the meeting during discussion. Seeing none, we have new senators that I'm going to introduce. So when I call on you, just kind of stand up, say a little bit about yourself and why you joined the SGA. So our freshman senator that was actually elected last week but wasn't able to make the meeting, Magdalena.
Hi, I'm a freshman senator. One of the reasons I joined the SGA, or something that I'd like to accomplish, is something that was brought up to me to make it more feasible for commuters to be part of life on campus in terms of like attending events, committee meetings, sports, the works.
Elected junior senator, Jake.
Hello everyone, Jake, 305 Mecki. One reason why I'm glad I'm finally in the SGA, I'm very into academics. I run some reviews, and a lot of times the kids in my reviews say that I do a better job than their actual teachers. So I'm very interested in the whole academic kind of thing, how the calculus town hall got going on, and I want to help that out and help get the actual classes better so people aren't relying on reviews as much. Although I love doing it.
Our newly elected senior seat, someone who is very familiar with the SGA, Jose.
Hi everyone, my name is Jose Angeles, 405, electrical engineering student. I've been part of the SGA for a while as a professional society subcommittee head. The goal that I want to accomplish is hopefully increase a little bit the diversity inclusion on campus through a bunch of different initiatives that we've already started. And I've also been very interested in health and wellness, as you guys have already figured that out. So thank you for having me.
And our second newly elected senior seat, Shamar.
Hello guys, my name is Shamar Yap, and I'm a 4-4 environmental engineer. So my area of focus would be in introducing or integrating more sustainability issues, or dealing with sustainability issues in the community. My motive for joining could be summed up in the instance of me walking around in the summer during the rain and the school had sprinklers running. I feel that a lot of the decisions that the campus makes, or like any of the facilities that they, most of the decisions that the facilities make, don't really make much sense, and if they really make sense, I'd like an explanation for it. So I look forward to working with all of you, and hopefully I can help you out.
So many of you know, and especially the older veterans of the SGA, know that we used to essentially just be a budgeting committee. I would attribute a lot of that change and growth to Matt Hunt. I was around during his presidency. He really started the ball rolling with getting the SGA and the Senate very active, taking on initiatives other than just budgeting, and really extending the scope of our influence and making a lot of improvements on campus. But since then, the senator requirements have not changed at all. And I'm in a little bit of a weird spot right now, because the SGA is incredibly active right now. I'm so proud of the Senate because you have all been doing a ton of awesome work, and yet half of you didn't meet your senator requirements for the last semester. I can't impeach half the Senate. I'm not going to bring all of you up for impeachment. In fact, I'm gonna put the list on the board right now. So Jesse, Matt, Melanie, TJ, Evan, Vantine, Ryan, Tom, Jimmy, Austin, Ben, Kean, Julia, Mira, Monica, Pratik, Tim, and Liam. You would all be up for impeachment later during this meeting. But I've decided not to. I'm going to ignore what happened last semester, for the most part because most of these people are committee heads. Two of them are on the oversight committee. I'm gonna let it go for right now. I'm pretty upset, but the Senate's been doing a lot of good. And I'm willing to acknowledge that the senator requirements could maybe use some change. For right now, they are what they are. And if none of you sent an email, and I'm going to be very strict for the rest of the semester, until they're changed, if they're changed this semester, if any of you do not meet your Senate requirements, such as the monthly emails, which I'm going to check probably after this meeting, you're just gonna be brought up for impeachment. That's just the way it's gonna work. I mean, like I said, we have a really active Senate. I'm sorry I have to do this. This is just kind of frustrating on my end, especially considering a lot of these are some of our most active senators. And I was a senator for 2 years. The senator requirements are really not that much. It's pretty easy to accomplish all of these. You're sending some emails, you're going to some events, getting free food. It's not much at all. For a lot of you, a lot of the Senate, I was the one who gave you the new Senate presentation and like kind of introduced you to the Senate. And something that I really harped on during all of those presentations that I gave was don't do the bare minimum. Go above. The bare minimum is for people who, you know, are just here as like a leadership position to put on their resume. Don't do the bare minimum. It's so easy to go above and beyond. There's so many resources that we all have to make change on campus. So I'm really upset that even though a lot of you are making change on campus, you couldn't do the bare minimum to stay a senator. Like I said, don't do the bare minimum. It's so easy to get all of this stuff done. That being said, I'm willing to acknowledge that some of this might need change, so the Oversight Committee and I are going to get together, and we're going to figure out if we can revamp these, make them better, update them. Besides that, oh, the other thing, since I'm deciding this is the meeting, I'm gonna be real strict about stuff. If you make a motion to, if you say, I motion to do something, I'm not gonna entertain it. That's not the way a motion works. I move to do something. That's the correct phrase. That's how a motion is started. You move to do something. If you say, I motion to do anything, or you know, motion to whatever, I'm just not gonna entertain it. It's gonna be an out of order motion. So, sorry to start the meeting off like that, but gotta be said.
DLC. All right, guys, so I finally had my meeting with Dean Nielsen. A lot of things came up, most of which I'll be updating you on next meeting. Still some stuff to discuss with him. But one thing that came out of it is that he said there's opportunities for students to get involved locally in Hoboken, and he's pushing for that, and figured it would be just good for me to put that plug in right here for anyone. You can contact me, and I'll get you two together, or even if you're close with him, just talk to him. But let me know if you have questions about that or want to get involved locally in Hoboken. Also, the library pilot program that we talked about last semester, it's going to start tomorrow. So the calendar should be updated. I spoke with the director of the library, and that's going to get going tomorrow, which is really good. We'll see how that goes. And also, to the new senators, welcome. If you're interested in making campus better, campus life committee meetings are 9 p.m. at Pierce Cafe every other Wednesday, and the next one is going to be this week. So, yeah.
You, CMB. In here? I don't think he is. I'll just read this. Weekly meeting time to be determined.
I think that's old in there.
Oh, is it old?
Yeah.
Old. Okay. All right. So, no update. EC.
Oh, okay. Sorry. Hold on. Okay. So this week's events that just happened, we had a coffee house on Friday. It was a relaxing event. I was there. It was cool. It was coffee, snacks, painting that you could do, and it was like pretty chill. Fun fact, Duck After Dark was created to discourage drinking on Friday nights. As you guys know, Friday night is midnight. last night we had the Devils game. They won. It was actually a really good game. I don't know if any of you went, but I was there. It was a lot of fun. Super Bowl parties today in Pierce. I don't know if you guys have been there yet, but EC was decorating there last night from 11 p.m. to 3 a.m. Just making sure everything was right. It's free for all students, even if you don't have a Pierce meal plan. EC is subsidizing the cost. EC does have a special relationship with Compass One. There's going to be prizes there, not paid by the SGA. It's paid by dining, so that's cool. Like Alexa and a Fire Stick. It's going to be real chicken wings. I don't know what big chicken wings are. Yeah. New England clam chowder and Philly cheesesteaks. So I'll see, we're doing the regional thing. That's pretty cool. Next week events, we have the Hunter Ski Trip, which is Saturday. So sign-ups are tomorrow night at 10 p.m. There's 100 spots. It fills up. So if you guys want to go, it's a cool day trip. You're there all day, and you'll be back at night. So that's fun. Sweeney Todd is next Sunday, February 11th, Prudential Center, which is super easy to get to, and I love the Prudential Center. Extra things, there's some e-board changes. There's an election for VP of off-campus that used to be me, now they have to replace me. There's a potential new VP of on-campus, there's a potential new arts chair, there's a potential new Duck After Dark chair. Yeah, so there's going to be a lot of elections coming up for them, a new restructure, it'll be a fun time. If you guys want to go to those meetings, they're Wednesday at 9 p.m. at Pierce 216. Let's go. Cool, that's it.
Thank you. PR.
Okay, welcome to the new senators again. And we have two more junior seats and two more senior seats to fill. On the next slide, which you'll see after this, there's actually a poster that I made for nominations. So we're gonna publicize that and hopefully with the third round of vacancy elections, get the final seats filled and have a full Senate. Also, you can post a tiny URL link so people can get to the Dublin page very easily. And once again, committee heads, once you have like a set time for your meetings, please let me know. And something I mentioned last meeting was restarting, I found out we tried this before, the Meet the Senators campaign on Instagram. And I think that it would be a good idea to start with the newly elected senators from the Constitution, just to ensure that people know who actually was elected, because since these are vacancy elections, it's like less publicized and fewer people are aware of like what's going on. So I think it would be great to introduce the student body to our newly elected senators first. And also, I want to advertise the extended library hours. Shout out to Jesse and Campus Select Committee, and we're going to have that. So I think a lot of people don't know that the extended hours are going to be starting, so I'm going to make posters and get that hung around campus. And also, if SGA, if your committee is doing like an SGA-sponsored event, make sure to add that event on DuckLink, because we actually aren't supposed to be able to get posters through Student Life and the copy room without the event being on DuckLink. So we have to remember that. And also the next PR meeting is the following Wednesday on the 14th at 2 p.m. in America's Cup. That's the poster.
Thank you. ACA.
Hey guys, keep sending these forms for the music tech and the business co-ops to your music tech and business friends. It's definitely super important to get more feedback on that. This Wednesday is the Calculus Town Hall. Please come. Talk about calculus. Talk about like why it's not good. What's good about it. There's free food. Meetings will be on Mondays at 4 p.m. in Babio 219. So new senators, if you want to come through. We're probably going to be talking about trying to get research or more research for students. If you have any ideas or anything about that topic, definitely go through and keep raising it.
Thank you. Barb.
Hi. So we actually just had our meeting, and our new meeting time is going to be at 6 p.m. on Sundays. So right before SGA meetings upstairs in probably Babio 212. We have two main initiatives this semester. One of them is the advertising the academic concern form. And the other one is gathering some information and data about what people think about the new changes to the academic break. We're going to do a district survey on the district's distribution form starting next week. And if you come to our meeting this week on Sunday, we're going to be talking about getting face-to-face publicity in other organizations. All right, and for the slide.
Thank you. Health and wellness. Melanie is not here.
I'll be doing her report in my report.
During your report?
Yeah. All
right. ESC.
Yeah,
okay. Subcommittee meeting last Tuesday. Everything seems fine right now. At events, there's a BSU SOCA Rhythms on Friday, February. Professional societies.
Not to mention it on here, but subcommittee meeting this Tuesday. American Society of Quality, step your organization. They're having their interest meetings this week. Save is making recycled candles, and Sweet is having a public speaking and interviewing event this week. So please follow those.
Thank you. Media report.
Hey,
AEC is having their first jam this Saturday at 5 p.m. If you want to help Eric over there with the camera film these meetings, you can join CTV. They meet Mondays at 9. Read the student.
Thank you. Special interests.
So there's a lot of events and museums coming up in the next couple weeks. I think the biggest one is Republicans having their CPAC on the 22nd. I'm also holding my subcommittee meeting on the 7th.
Words of music.
Okay, so hi everyone. So the new subcommittee head will be Fernando Hernandez, who will be replacing me. We just had our meeting on Wednesday, the 31st. It's about 9:00. Everyone else is doing okay so far as I know, as far as they are going to tell me. And some of the first shows and other shows happen for a lot of time.
Thank you. Recreation.
She couldn't be here today, but this should be changed, I guess, to dissolution of golf club. That's on the docket for later today. That's all.
Thank you. Electronics and gaming.
This is James.
Meeting times below, mildly outdated.
This is old news.
All right. Community service.
Jamie? Nope. This is old news.
Gotcha. Update. Founders Day Ball.
Hey guys, Founders Day Ball tickets come out tomorrow. Just a reminder, there are no offline tickets. You can't buy with cash, so it's all online to make sure you tell your districts and friends and stuff. New senators, make sure you click the link here to obtain your free SGA Founders Day Ball ticket because you have to do that soon, otherwise you're going to lose your chance. If you can't come or don't want to go for some reason, still sign up and say that you can just give away your ticket to someone else because that's important. And over here is the link where you can buy tickets tomorrow. So make sure you have that in your district emails.
When do the ticket sales open?
Oh, I said noon.
Oh, okay. All right.
Thanks.
Tickets. All right. Welcome, new senators. It's really nice to see some new faces, some new blood in the Senate. I had a meeting with Melanie and the rest of the task force, the health task force, which is comprised of Celine from athletics, Maggie, who's the director of the health center, Dr. Eric Rose, who's the director of CAPS, and Phil Gaiman, who's the director of disability services. We talked a lot about some stuff, and what was really nice is that they were really receptive to our feedback. It was pretty clear in the meeting that they had no idea what students wanted or no idea what students had resources to. So we talked a lot about implementing some of our ideas into what they have planned. So one thing that I didn't know that we had was that we're a GED campus, which means that we're committed to talking about mental health, preventing suicide, and working to do more alcohol and drug abuse workshops. So we're not using any of the resources that are sponsored by GED. Which is basically this program that helps us do these things. So they'll be coming into campus and doing some audits on like what the Stevens student population is like. So we're actually gonna be using them because the school spends $22,000 a year to be part of this program, but we don't use any of the services. So it sort of seems like they're just using it to put on our resume. So we'll definitely be utilizing a lot of those things that GED offers. And in that, I'll be giving Melanie's report, which I guess is pretty similar to what I would be saying about the meeting that we had. So the members of the task force were really interested to hear what we had to say about students and the issues that were being faced on campus. A big thing that the members hinted to us was the fact that we should push the school to be more student-centric and really vocalize the things that we had to say as students about the issues that are being faced. The need to have a health educator on campus and to be the resource for students on all things health, sexual, physical, drugs, and alcohol, et cetera. The next goal of the group is to have a talk about during meetings is to improve and expand our current system of identifying students at risk, meaning students who might be facing some type of mental illness that has began to impact them and their schoolwork. Other things for Melanie, still no new update on smoking, but I have a meeting with Dean Nielsen this week, so that it actually got to HR, so human resources, which is good because it usually takes a long time for them to actually implement anything. So hopefully we'll be seeing some more updates on a smoke-free campus soon.
And a huge thank you to all the senators sending me photos of the dispensers. And keep on looking throughout the weeks. We've gotten so many photos, so hopefully those empty signs will no longer be there. And to new senators, if anyone's interested in learning more about the Health and Wellness Committee, please feel free to reach out to me with any and all questions. So what she said in her report is that what the administration needs is student feedback on if we actually want a health educator. So a health educator would basically take the place of organizations like Torch, who do all sexual health education for all of campus, which frankly is pretty ridiculous. So we would bring in someone, hopefully, that would be in charge of doing all these different programs for students about like sexual health, mental health, and different things like that. Because right now, it's really the brunt of the work is on student organizations. It's not provided by the university. So probably what we're gonna need is a proclamation, and I know Melanie is starting to work on that. So if anybody's interested in writing a proclamation to really show that students would want something like this, please feel free to reach out to her or reach out to me. So I'll probably be intimately involved in actually writing it. Other things, so they created a new housing selection process. It's actually way easier this year. Housing applications opened February 1st, and they'll be open until February 28th. So if you're planning on living through Stevens, make sure to read all the things that they sent you. It's way easier than it was in the past. And we fixed up the old, so when you're a freshman, you're applying for roommates, they had some really outdated questions, like asking if you brought a record, if you would bring a record player, or like if you listen to a Walkman. So I worked with them to like redo that whole application process and hopefully match roommates up better. Because right now, well, in the past, it was pretty ridiculous. Okay, so I had another meeting to talk about the student government's transparency, and I guess especially the cabinets. So I guess in order to be as transparent as possible, not only can anyone reach out to me and we can get a coffee or talk about whatever you want SGA-wise, we're also going to start posting committee meeting minutes on DuckLink. So committee heads or whoever you delegate to take minutes at your meetings, make sure that you're actually doing that, because we're gonna upload it on DuckLink. Hopefully it'll help more people understand what our committees actually do, and hopefully people will decide to join them. Besides that, make sure to send out all the emails that are required by PR. I know this was a problem in the past, but Nick is definitely gonna be checking in on you actually sending out the emails that are required. Another thing that I talked about was a Greenovation Fund. So it'd be a set amount of money allocated to sustainability. So it would be maybe $15,000. What it would be is students would be able to apply this to do sustainability projects for the Stevens campus. It's in the works, and I'm talking to Frank Lavasco, the director of facilities, and eventually Bob Mafia about this possibility, and I'll let you know. A really cool thing that happened this week, they consolidated peer mentors and orientation leaders into one position. So now you're gonna be a peer leader. The peer mentor program in the past was useless. They didn't really do much. My peer mentor, when they met with me the first time, was like, I don't wanna be here, you don't wanna be here, so we can just hang out for an hour. So right now, they're consolidating those two positions so that an orientation leader will be an orientation leader during the summer and within the first semester. So you'll have the 2 weeks before school starts, but also throughout the semester, you'll have to do different things with your orientation group.
Yeah. So to clarify, if you were looking to be an orientation leader the following year, you would apply to be a peer leader?
Yeah, it's the same application process. Just now there's a little more added to the peer leader job. Yeah. It'll be really nice because hopefully we can also implement some more programs that we want to put on for new students there. And then, I guess to wrap it up, I had a meeting with Dave Zimmerman. He's the bomb, and he wants to help us out with a lot of different things on campus. He has a lot of insight into past campus traditions. And Dave Zimmerman's the director of university events.
Cool. Thank you.
Robbie.
Hey everyone, so like you probably saw on the docket, I'm appointing Tim as chair of the website committee, pending your approval, obviously. So if any of you are interested on being on the committee, either talk to me or Tim, if he gets approved, which I think more hopefully. So thanks to all the freshmen for participating in rotations. Sorry, I know that's kind of been like a bit messy. That's just because it's still beginning of semester, not everyone has figured out their meeting times. I'll send out an updated schedule this week or in the coming few days, probably in the form of spreadsheets so it's more organized. So welcome to our new junior and senior senators. If you want to participate in committee rotations, you can, let me know. I know you guys probably have some experience with SGA or have a good grasp of what we do, especially Jose. But if you want to participate, that's fine too. And like Lucas said, a student raised a valid concern that we haven't published committee meeting minutes before. Not because we don't want to, just because we never have. So for committee chairs, I'll be making sure that, I know I said I wouldn't be like a hard ass with it, but like I will now. Please upload your minutes in a timely fashion to the committees of the SGA folder on the drive. And Lukes and I will be attending COSCA, that's the Conference on Student Government Associations. That's the weekend of February 23rd. We're hoping to learn more about how other SGAs function and what they do to get like their opinions across and all that. So yeah, we'll be bringing that knowledge here, hopefully.
Yeah. Do you, I just want to remind everyone real quick, please try not to use profanity during the meetings.
Sorry.
Like, keep it professional.
My bad.
Nice. All
right, congratulations on being 2.6 work weeks in, everybody. It's a good job. We only have like 14 left, so. Welcome to all the new senators. I think there's four of you I haven't seen yet in here, so congratulations. Welcome, Fernando, when he comes next week, I guess.
Yeah.
And also welcome back, my voice. So the first meeting of the Committee on Student Interest is going to be this Wednesday, so I apologize there hasn't been a lot coming from me lately, but I finally set up meetings with all of my subcommittee heads, so we're going to get working on actually getting some traction down and rewriting a couple of documents. We have one or two clubs presenting to the subcommittee head meeting on Wednesday to go into step three of the new organization process. If you have any questions about that, you can let me know. We also have two organizations presenting tonight. One is Redshift, looking for probationary status, and one is Poetry Club, looking for RSO status. So that's in the agenda under docket items, so you guys please keep your eyes open. We have one organization also to discuss deactivation tonight. SACE has a big conference coming up on Saturday in Jersey City, just letting everybody know. So if you see anybody who's on the e-board of SACE and they look like they aren't sleeping this week, it's because they aren't, and help them out. CITTV is having problem for physical plant, and they're being looked into by both Anthony and myself. If any of you know of any other organizations who are getting strange physical plant charges, please let either Anthony or me know, and let these organizations know that if they do have questions about why they're being charged, they don't have to blindly pay it, they can ask. So bowling, as we discussed last week, has been added to the Duckling quote-unquote deactivated pile. I think there's about five or six clubs in there right now. And in regards to the new organization process that's ongoing, it's open for another week. We are 1 week in. I've had 9 new club requests, and 5 meetings so far have been set up. And that's what I got.
Thank you. Anthony?
Hello. So today was a fun budget meeting. We had 21 AFR/reallocations that we voted on. Dakota and I are not pushovers, and we know how to say no when it's warranted, so we only recommend about a third of what was requested. Some of it was objective cuts, some of it was just large amounts of money and they had no representatives, but we'll go into that one time. We still have a budget committee vacancy. I still want to wait until like we have a full Senate before we appoint someone. Still, if you're interested, send me an email that doesn't just say I'm interested. Give me like a reason why you're interested. That'd be cool. Have my office hours from 7 to 8 every Wednesday in the SGA office. People came. They were nice. No one yelled at me. No one choked me like that cat. It was great. Sarah and Jake. Who's Sarah and who's Jake? I'm sorry. I don't see, where are you guys?
It's us here.
You okay. Okay. Where's Sarah? Sarah, not here? Oh, hey. I missed you in my budget committee, or were you there? And I just didn't see you. It's fine. No, you're not in trouble. Don't worry. It's fine. I was just sad that you weren't there.
When was it?
Today? Yeah.
Oh, the email said it was at
6
or
5.
I was
That was a mistake on my part, but next time, come.
I was just kind of going. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Okay. But yeah, I was sad. Well, I'm sorry I wasn't there. Jake was there. But I didn't know you were there. You should have said something.
We love you.
Call
you
back.
But yeah, that's it for me. We'll go over my 21 budget today.
Cool.
Thank
you.
Carry on.
Alright, so welcome new senators. Last week I was really sick and had to cancel some stuff, which made me sad, but I did not want to infect everybody or puke on anyone, so I stayed home. I did get to meet with Vice Provost Chaspis, which was good, and we're going to put together an agenda and meet with the co-op office to talk about their many problems. Some of you know what those are. I also met with Dean Thomas to continue my transition meetings that Hannah so lovely has set up. Card ACA had their first meetings. They've got some great stuff going on. So if you're interested in academic stuff, new people, please stop by. Their committee slides have when they meet. Got some good stuff going on. I'm also working on coordinating with Dean Nielsen, Rob Mafia, and some other key people, some like job site tours of the Gianforte Family Center, just because we have a lot of engineers on campus who will be working on construction sites one day. Or maybe you're not in the field and you're just interested because it's like a huge construction project in your face all day. So I'm trying to work on doing some tours because I know I always ask like the super when I see him, like, what's going on? So I'm a big civil nerd. So working on that, I'll keep you all posted. Coming up this week, I'm doing my last turnover meeting finally with the provost. Apparently he's busy or whatever, so I can't just like show up whenever I want. We also rescheduled with Professor Jew to work out some cool stuff with SFA and the committee for the SES stuff. And then ACA also told you before they're having their town hall, and that's super exciting, and I'm looking forward to it. That's all I got.
Thank you.
Regan.
Hey, guys. Congrats and welcome to the new senators. We're really excited to have you. I want to say thank you to everybody who signed up to be a senator mentor. I'm going to be reaching out to all the mentors and mentees sometime soon. I want to set up like a dinner with all you guys so you guys can hang out and stuff. We have more vacancy elections. This will be the last round that we're running. We still have two junior seats and two senior seats open. So like, please tell your friends to run. Nominations opened today at 1 for the next round. The vacancy elections will close Wednesday at 1, and voting opens on Thursday, and we'll close next Sunday. So right here is the Senate. You can fill out your senator shout-outs, which I'm going to start reading at meetings. So like, if someone does something super cool and you want to like shout them out, send those in. Working on the logo. Once we get like more finalized stuff, I'm going to be sharing it with you guys. Also, we want to coordinate a Senate dinner or like a fun event for all of you, so look out for a doodle about that coming Sunday. Also, it was a birthday Saturday, so 21st.
Watch out. Didn't hear a second. Still don't. So we're continuing with discussion. Let's saw their hands. Matt.
This might be something we could fix, like as a clerical change. At the bottom of the minutes, there was a few like outside the Senate, and That's just because we didn't know the person's name that spoke, but I think that's important to find out who spoke at the minutes, and, I mean at the meeting, and to put that in the minutes, rather than give them an anonymous name.
Okay, that's actually something I could just change in the future. I mean, normally when I call on a guest that I don't know their name, I kind of just point at them. So I think in the future, when I do that, I'll ask them to state their name before they say whatever they're going to say, and that'll help with the minutes. So yeah, that's something that I can change in the future. Reed.
I'd just like to say about the minutes, like, as an appointed, I've been appointed to this position of secretary, and it's like my main, one of my main jobs is to do the minutes. And I know it's kind of like hard to say about this week because John was my pro tempore last week, but like, I was appointed to this position, I was approved by you. I think that you need to like respect your own decision in that and kind of like nip this in the bud, like I'm taking minutes. And if you have problems with them, like you can reach out to me, but I don't think that we should be amending the minutes every week. Like that's not something I'm cool with. So.
And going off that, you know, students, yes, this is what we're showing them on DuckLink, but if they really want to find out the every detail that's going on in these minutes or these meetings, why don't they just come out to the meetings as we always say they can. The minutes are a great summary of what's going on, and I'm not saying we should take it lightly, but, you know, I was taking the minutes last week, and it's tough. You can't get everything in there. But I'm glad, you know, we got Sit TV helping us out here, so, yeah.
Isabella.
And I think from a Sunday reporting point of view, we keep spending like 15, 20 minutes every week on this. We're going to be not focusing on what's really important, like the real changes that we want to see, and just clear up this up. Because like John said, they can come to the meeting if they really want to, and they should. I think the minutes are just a great way to summarize, and I think they're going to help us.
Lisa.
So, I'm like, I understand like you can't get everything perfect like with what people said, and like summarizing is great, otherwise the transcript would be really long, but some things are just really blatantly wrong, like all of the motions weren't written properly, and the names were spelled incorrectly, and the attendance was wrong, and the budget committee details said that we have 10 AFRs, $10,000 each, and that's really wrong. So I think that we deserve better than this from our minutes. We can approve the minutes we think we deserve, but I don't think we deserve these. So that's why I'm on the table.
Okay, I want to make 2 points real quick. This was sort of a one-off because this was coming from the pro tempore, which was John, which was his first time doing the minutes. And I understand the need for the accuracy in the minutes, so that's valid. If there are clerical changes we can make, we'll make them. You could also bring this up to Regan outside of the Senate meeting, especially if they're clerical changes, because like I said, these are things that if they're just blatantly incorrect and not necessarily a matter of, like that's the kind of stuff that can change outside of the meeting. And also, let's just make sure that we're not targeting anyone. I'd like to make sure that this conversation kind of stays reasonable and not insulting to anyone.
For the budget committee update, like that's what he said. Might not be accurate, but that might be a mistake when he was speaking. So it's what he said. Just remember him saying that. I was going to point it out. I was like, wait, what?
Chester.
Move to previous.
Okay. All in favor of moving to previous, please say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, please say nay. All in favor of approving the minutes from January 21st. Is that?
28.
Yeah, 28. All in favor of approving the minutes from January 28th. Please say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, please say nay.
Nay.
Okay, motion passes. You're now in new business. Jesse.
Move to approve recommendations of the budget committee.
Sorry. Anthony,
go ahead. It's going to take about 2 hours.
Okay. So our starting operating budget this week was $58,885.95. Total amount requested through AFRs was $15,405.26. That number does not include reallocation requests because you guys do not approve those. They will be on the, like, they'll be the last few slides. but you guys are approving all the AFRs, not the reallocation requests. We recommended $5,780.26 of AFRs, and if that is approved by you guys, our remaining operating budget will be $53,105.69.
I'd like to point out, just remind everybody, that if there is anything in this slideshow you have a question on, these are not final, you're voting on these and you can change these. So if you have a suggestion, if anybody in the back would like a senator to make a motion, they can suggest that. If a senator would like to ask more, they can.
Yeah, so especially since there's 21 of them, I'm gonna keep it high level, and if you guys have any specific questions, feel free to raise your hand and we'll call on you. But yeah, let's get the show on the road. Okay, so ASQ, American Society of Quality, they are a new organization, so they were allowed to request up to $200 for their semesterly budget. They requested $146. We suggest cutting it to $100 because in our guidelines, you're only allowed $100 per month on food for general body meetings, and so we had to objectively cut it to $100. That was approved. Attila Entrepreneurs, it was just their semesterly budget request. They're allowed up to $1,000. If you want to go into it, we can. All the events seem really cool. And it was all within our budgeting guidelines, and we didn't have a problem approving them for their $1,000. West Indian Student Organization, another new organization. They're only allowed up to $200. And it was all within our budgeting guidelines, and we didn't see a problem giving them the $200. SUMAC requested $4,300 because they did not submit a budget last semester because they were late. The AFR they gave me was not very detailed. Like, it was just kind of like, yeah, we need $3,000 for this performance, and then some earplugs for $300, and no one came to represent themselves. We had a lot of questions, so anything big, we're just going to try to deny, especially if there's so many questions. We're not in the, what did Houston say last semester? We're not in the business of approving, of assuming. There we go. We're not in the business of assuming, and I agree with that, so we voted to deny. NSBE, this was tabled from last week, $600 for additional funding for a conference. I think we're going to continue to deny this until we get some confirmation that people actually signed up for this. They also had no representative, and later on you'll see SWIX also had a conference allocation, and we approved them because they actually had the conference confirmations that it was paid for by the students going, so then we were comfortable approving it. So I think in the future we're going to wait for that from all organizations. PBL was approved $755 for additional speaker fees. I met with their treasurer or someone on their e-board Wednesday during my office hours. They explained why they already had $245 requested and they needed the extra $755 to bring it up to $1,000. It's actually a co-sponsored event with College Republicans and SWIB and some external organization called YAF. The speaker actually costs $25,000. Dr. Laffer, I've never heard of him, but he seems cool. I looked him up. PBL is going to be putting in $1,000. SWIB is putting in $500, and College Republicans already have $6,100 allocated. There's an external organization called YAF that is footing the bill for the rest, which is about $18,000. The School of Business is into this. They're going to be hosting a reception afterwards that the School of Business is going to be paying for, and it's going to be a good networking event too. So, okay. Oh. Yeah.
Did you say $18,000?
SWIB, the external organization?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, yeah. So that's not money coming from us. That's from just some others. ICHE requested $1,000 for an industry tour. They said it was for transportation. They had no e-board representation. They said they had a bus quote, but they didn't know where they were going, so I was like, how does that work? And they didn't really have a rep, so we didn't feel comfortable approving it. They had another AFR for a $100 bowling event. This was kind of like a networking thing. This fell within our guidelines, and we were comfortable approving it. FAME requested $75 for an online magazine subscription. IEEE requested $120, later amended it to $130 because they did a miscalculation. They just needed two instead of one of that. I don't know what that is, but so that was approved. Stevens Hobby Robotics was approved $700 for an event like Battle Blimps or something. It seemed really cool, and it was within our budgeting guidelines, so we approved it. SDS requested $3,000 for a choreographer. They had no representative, and it was just like, yeah, we need a choreographer for $3,000, and we weren't comfortable approving it. Sit TV, complicated. But, so basically, there's two accounts with Student Life for Sit TV. All the SGA funding was put in one, but a lot of charges were coming out of the other, so they were running at a deficit, but the other account had a surplus, so that surplus rolled back to the SGA because we saw it as unspent funds, but it actually was spent, but it was just in the wrong account. So this is just to reconcile that. The money was spent already, but it wasn't their fault. It was just like an accounting fault with the school. We also cut it $114 because some of those charges were like physical plant, like replacing the door and like other stuff like that, and we're not sure if we should be paying for that, so we just wanted to have a conversation with Sit TV, Dakota and I, and Student Life to see what we should actually be paying for and what should be considered like a facilities school paying for it kind of thing. Software engineering wanted to have a general body meeting, and they requested $125. It's not allowed. They're only allowed 100, so we cut it. SWIB wanted $300 for a workshop. It's all that they gave me. They gave me the date and time and who was coming, but like not what that $300 was for. Like, was it food or speaker fees? So we denied it. SWIX requested $150 for coffee and code. This is an event that they've had for the last two semesters. It's not allowed, according to our budgeting guidelines, because we're paying for food for off-campus events. So we recommended to deny it, and we're gonna be meeting with them to figure out what we should do in the future about these events. Because I know they were successful, but it's just a flat-out objective cut that they're not allowed to keep doing it. Because I've been to these events in the past, and they're cool, but like they're not allowed. So. SWIX asked for another $200 for two more students to go to the conference. They had the conference confirmation from the students that they're actually going, so there was no problem in that. Only four more, five more. Thon, this is request number two. I don't know why it came before number one, but they wanted $100 for general body food. They already had a general body meeting with food this month, so they can't do it again because it would be over $100, so we denied it. ANS, this is reallocations now, so I'm just letting you guys know. But they reallocated $500 from one tour to another because they didn't have enough money for the bus. Because the quote was more than they expected, so we didn't see a problem with that. Thon wanted $100 reallocated. The representative here didn't know where it was coming from, and specifically what it was going to, and we're like, you should know this, so come back when you do know it. Newman Catholic wanted $30, I forget for what, but Dakota, do you know what the $30 was for Newman Catholic?
Reallocating from food to supply.
Oh yeah, food to food supplies, like 14 napkins. We're like, okay, $30. So, any questions, concerns, comments? Oh yeah.
On Sit TV's request, they said they're requesting $47.06 for Google Sign. Is that like a digital service, or is that like a physical sign that says Google?
Bill, would you have any
questions? Do you repeat the question, Abby?
It says $47.76 for Google Sign. Is that a service, or is that like a physical LED sign?
I don't know why it says Google Sign. We have a sign that says recording that we're planning to hang up outside of our doors so people know we're recording. I don't know why it says Google, because the domain was through Google. But that's just a sign.
Okay. Any other questions, discussion? Lisa.
What was that one slide that had like two votes? One
That just means we voted on it, and then I had a question after we voted on it. But we were already in the motion to vote, so we had to continue with the vote. And so it was voted on to approve, two votes for yes, none for no, four abstentions. And I brought up the point that they already had an event, so that it didn't happen. So we re-voted on it. And, sorry.
Discussion. Anything else?
Second.
Okay. All in favor of moving previous, please say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, please say nay. Okay, all in favor of approving the recommendations of the Budget Committee, please say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, please say nay. Motion passed. Order of business. Dan.
I move to instate Arbitry Club as full status RSO.
Second. Okay. Dakota, do you want to speak?
Sure. So I have been speaking on and off with representatives from Poetry Club. I believe they have one or two members here today. Three. Do you guys have a presentation ready, or would you like to?
Yeah, I have like one.
So okay.
Yeah, that's fine. You can either email it to me, or you can just plug your computer in.
Can I do like USB?
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah.
Okay. So just so everybody knows, while Kelly's coming up here. Poetry Club are currently a Step 4 organization, meaning they're in the probationary period. This means that they are essentially a recognized organization, but they are capped at a maximum of $1,000 per semester. Are they under media or arts and music?
Arts and music.
Do you have any additional comments?
They don't
okay.
have any, they don't give me any issues.
All right.
$750, I think it all adds up to. So $350 for our poetry night, which is like an open mic. We sometimes do like a bigger one, and then this semester we're thinking of doing like a small event with like a bookstore. So that it's for like food and drinks if we have two. It might be like less if we do one event, we might only spend like $200. $250 is for printing our zines. So we have like these, I would pass them around. There's only like a few, but we basically, once a semester, we have like a collaborative mini book of like poetry and like art from the members. So each person like does their slide, and for I think it's 200 of these. It's $250.
So can I show them that one? All those gray ones.
So yeah, so that's what that's for. $100 for like general body baby snacks. Like we have a Valentine's Day themed love phone thing, so I'm gonna buy candy for that. And then $50 for stuff like paper and pens and markers, cause like to write poetry. Our attendance at our poetry nights is anywhere from like 20 to 60 people. Last semester we had 37 students attend, which I know like it's definitely not as much as like a lot of other clubs, but keep in mind that when reading poetry, if you're presenting to, you know, like 70 people, it's kind of intimidating. So for us, it's like nicer to have more like intimate groups. Same for our meetings. We do have some meetings where like not that many people show up. Other meetings for like some of our like special events where we do like a special workshop, we'll have up to like 20 people. And we had our first meeting last Tuesday. We had 12 students attend. And then lastly, our purpose, whether we've like been sticking to this. So it was to provide a creative outlet, obviously, we do more than just poetry. Like, through our books, we do, like, photography and drawing. We do, like, a lot of, like, collage and stuff. So it's definitely, like, catered toward poetry, but we kind of foster appreciation for, like, the arts in general. And, yeah, read, write, perform poetry in a safe and welcoming environment. It's really cool when we have, like, a new person just show up and just, like, share their poetry that we've, like, they've never attended. Like, they just feel comfortable with them to do that, so that's cool. And then, yeah, the zines, that was the last thing. So, are there any questions?
Yeah, so do you guys have competition for poetry?
We do, yeah.
Would you like to see it?
Yes.
Okay.
You can email it to me and I'll pull it up.
Oh, that works.
In the meantime, if any other questions or discussion?
So you say for your first DVM last year you had 12 people.
Yeah.
Do you expect to have more this semester?
Yeah, it really depends like how well they do with PR.
Okay.
So like last semester we had a lot of like new freshmen. And we're trying to really like retain our attendance rates each time, like emailing or posters and such. So yeah, we're hoping to keep it. You know, last semester half of our meetings had maybe like under 10, half of them had 20.
Okay.
So it really is like it ranges, but we're hoping to keep it. You know.
Because I was gonna say, I think it was $100 for the first meeting snacks. That jumped out as a little high for me, but I don't know if.
Oh no, it was for like the whole semester.
Oh, a whole semester.
Yeah, so like we might spend 20 on one and then like 40 on the other.
Perfect. Sounds good.
Any other discussion? In the meantime, Regan.
I just want to say that I've been to poetry club and it's like super good and gone really well and awesome. So,
thank you. I also do have our constitution in my drive.
Okay, no, it's like actually, I'm just pulling it up right.
Okay.
So, thank you. Let me know what
Ronnie. Just to clarify something, because I know Dakota is busy sending that email. In order for them to be a step 3 probationary RSO, which they are, they would need to have submitted up their constitution to CMB already. That's all been approved in the past, just for clarity.
Okay. Lisa, did you have anything specific you wanted to address on?
Sure.
Okay. Like Ronnie said, it's already been approved by CMB. Are there any other questions about anything? Discussion? John?
Move the previous?
Aye. All in favor of moving the previous, please say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, please say nay. All in favor of stating the poetry club as a full status RSO, please say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, please say nay. Congratulations.
So I talked about this last week. People ask me like, what kind of a
resources and skills that we need on the team for this ad hoc committee. And I was thinking more of a sense where if anyone had a specialized feature that they would want added, and they also had, like, that was within their skill set, they could join the team and, you know, if someone had a really in-depth, like, surveying resource or something in the website, they could come in and add it themselves. I'm definitely looking for a good graphic designer. I know Regan was talking about, you're personally working on the logo.
Yeah.
You want to join?
But
it's definitely a collaborative effort, and I invite anyone that thinks they could add something to the website to reach out to me. This is if I guess it is. It's more of where it depends what kind of direction we take this in. So obviously someone's a good, you know, team member is productive, knows what they're doing a little bit. Don't be afraid to not know what you're doing.
I just said that I'm really looking forward to working with this committee. I also want to give a shout out to Stoss, who's in the back of Poetry Club, because she's helping us make that logo. So.
Woo!
I just wanted to ask about, like, the main premise or, like, purpose for the website. Is it more for, like, feedback or information?
So there's been talk about actually making a website for a long time. As I said, that was a big, yearly goal last year. Certain points that would make it more useful than Duckling. Duckling is where we put all of our files and stuff in general, but this is probably going to be more of a social media type medium thing where everything can kind of collaborate in one area. Maybe a newsletter could be directly important to it. You can add some sort of Twitter API to, like, hook everything up. It'll just be everything SGA.
Any other questions for Jen? See none. Jen, can you please step out? Any other discussion?
I was going to say, I had a lot of classes with Tim outside the SGA. He has good work ethic, and I think he's a good candidate for the job.
Cool. Jesse,
move to previous.
All favor of moving to previous. We'll see.
Congratulations, Tim.
Awesome. Morning business. What's that?
I move to revoke the RSO status of Belfry.
Okay.
Go.
Yeah. All right. So their subcommittee head can't be here. But she and I have reached out to Golf Club. Well, first, this came to my attention because they didn't show up at Leadership Reconnect. So I sent them an email saying, hey, where were you? No response. Their subcommittee had sent out an email saying, hey, we have a subcommittee meeting coming up. No response. So I sent out an email to them saying, hey, you're being brought up at the SGA meeting to be revoked. No response. The one response we did get was from their email alias for their e-board. It was from a student who graduated in 2016, and he told me, shut this club down. So, just to fill everybody in, their current semesterly budget is $0. They were asked multiple times last semester, that was because of a budgeting problem last semester. Because of that, they were asked several times to reach out to the Student Faculty Alliance and the Office of the Provost to set up events for last semester and this semester. They were invited to three meetings in which the same thing was told to them. All three times they effectively said no. Their Ducklink page is not registered on Ducklink, which means they have not used it since at least August. However, one weird thing did happen where their last recorded event was in November on Ducklink, but there is a page error which says that they can't track attendance. Their penultimate event was in last spring, and there was also a page error which shows no attendance. Like I said, they didn't attend Leadership Reconnect. They only have two e-board members. They're currently in bad standing not only because of last year's budgeting, they're also in bad standing for lack of events. They're also in bad standing for not attending Leadership Reconnect. They're also in bad standing for not attending any subcommittee meetings last semester. They have not responded, like I said, to either me or Monica regarding subcommittee meetings, Leadership Reconnect, or the deactivation of their organization. So their previous e-board member, their subcommittee head, and I all suggest we dissolve this organization.
Jesse. All in favor of the previous, please say aye.
But.
We're in business. Dan.
I move to instate redshift as probationary RSO.
Second.
Okay. Yes, do you have a presentation to give?
I don't have like a presentation other than the paper that we submitted. So basically, we have our constitution approved. We were able to get the attendance for two meetings in last semester, and as well as Chris Shemansky agreed to be our faculty advisor. Our budget is rather low, I believe. Per academic year, it's less than $2,000. It's mostly just to upkeep the website. So the whole basis of the club is to be around this website, which is serves as an online creative magazine. So similar to the Poetry Club, we will be like forwarding the arts, but it's to a wider scope. Two main events that we're trying to host for one is Red Talks, which we're trying to get up and running this semester, which is similar to TED Talks, as the name might suggest, which is kind of seminars in things that students feel strong, believe that they have skills in or want to, you know, educate more people on campus about relating to the creative realm, as well as we want to push for a creative showcase on campus, similar to when On Point was a thing one time, where the entire campus is kind of enveloped in this arts display of things that are created by Stephen students. Because we believe that there is a lot of creativeness in the students at Stevens, it just doesn't get a lot of showtime. So what we aim to do as a club is to give showtime to the creativeness of the students at Stevens.
Good. All right, so just for a little more background for everybody, in moving into their probationary period, they will be moving out of step three of the new organization process and into step four. This means, alongside other things, they will have access to a DuckLink account, they will be able to budget through DuckLink, and they will also be able to use virtual EMS to get rooms. Alongside this, they will be moving up from a maximum of $200 per semester to $1,000 per semester. And I have up here, I sent this to Mick a little while ago, can you scroll up for me real quick?
Yeah.
The main tenets of being in step three and moving into step four are that you have to finalize an executive board, hold a minimum of two interest meetings, finish drafting a constitution, obtain a faculty advisor, and draft a theoretical budget and events list. So if any senators have any questions regarding any of these for redshift, that would be what I would suggest you ask.
Discussion. Back.
So how and why did you choose your faculty advisor?
I settled on Christian Massey because I was researching the old redshift when it existed back in 2015. And he was the old advisor. So I went and met with him at my first, when I was like, hey, this is redshift, this is a thing. He's on the website of the old redshift. Let me go talk to him before I actually start to bring it back. So I had a couple meetings with him talking about why it died, what we're going to have to focus on to make sure it stays alive longer than the old redshift, because I believe this is the third or fourth reiteration of redshift. So, and every time it was because it didn't have sustainability and kind of the same people headed it the entire time, then once they graduated, they didn't build enough following for people to build it after them. He was a big help of kind of pointing me in the right direction and showing me the things that I really need to focus on to make sure that this can stay alive past when I'm gone.
Any other questions, discussion? Jesse.
Previous.
Can I see their budget?
Has it been
I don't think that was 5 minutes, so we're going to reopen discussion. Did you have a point?
Yeah, I just would like to see that budget.
Okay.
We don't have that.
Do we have that?
I don't have it. Do you have one?
Yeah, I have. Yeah.
Okay. Could you bring it up? Or send it to Nick, I guess.
Yeah, if you could just send it to me, that'd be easier. Any other discussion in the meantime while we're waiting for that? Questions? Angelina?
What exactly is RegShift?
Go ahead.
Well, I want
to see. I'm sorry, could you state your name before you?
Yeah, I'm Nasir. I'm the managing editor of RegShift. I'm a freshman, and I started talking to Jaleen about this project over the summer. It's something I'm really interested in. I think students have a lot of potential to show all the creative energy that's here. And so RegShift in the past, since we've had 3 or 4 iterations, it was this application, and basically it's just students submitted works and they published it, and it was like this really nice magazine, but as Julian said, it just wasn't sustainable. So what we're trying to do now, instead of just printing a magazine, now we're gonna have events. So we're doing Red Talks, which is essentially the TED Talks, and we're also trying to host a creative showcase. In terms of the work submitted, we have a drive with all user submissions. So not only are we getting students, we also have faculty. So like there's a professor, Lainey Buffman, she submitted one of her songs, and she's also interested in hosting one of the Red Talks. So that'll be a way for students who are like in engineering or any other major that's not in Cal to like see what that world is really like, since she'll be hosting one of those. And yeah, so RegShift, it's just like a creative hub, and I'm really excited about it. And
if I may expand on that, more details about the website, is part of the reason why we pushed it to the website is another problem that they had was the cost of printing. The fact that when you have a website, it's more accessible to everybody, as well as easier to maintain past, once the one person that knows how to print graduates. And that seemed like a much better way to maintain a publication like this. Also, we're gonna be looking for interviews with creators at Stevens, or ones that are deemed successful that come to us with multiple submissions, that we deem warrant an interview and things like that. Also, Nick,
cool. Here's the budget. Mira, did you have anything specific that you wanted to point out, or you just wanted to see it? So here's the budget.
Most of the things are little funds for public relations, mostly posters, flyers, Facebook, Instagram ads, small prints. The most expensive thing we have is looking into possible special edition prints, once per semester, probably max, if not once a year.
John?
Why do you need money for Facebook and Instagram?
That was mostly for ads, targeted for within the region. But within the Stevens, Hobo community, it is a publication.
Oh, okay. So.
Yeah,
I was about to say, so it's not the same as just posting on a page, you're actually buying.
Yeah, this is the ads that when you scroll through, in the sidebar, they pop up, and it goes kind of in.
Lisa?
Is there also a constitution for RegShift?
Yes.
Senate?
Yeah, and then else one of you does. I don't know, I just wanted to point out that one of our guidelines is a maximum of $300 per semester on promotional items. They haven't hit it, but they get close. So I just want to let everybody know.
Okay, any other discussion? Questions? Anything? We are on.
Motion to close.
Second.
Okay, all in favor of closing, please say aye.
Aye.